Hey there, ever wondered how JavaScript stores all that cool data like numbers, text, and more? Today we're looking at JavaScript variables. So what are variables? Imagine you've got a treasure chest where you can stash gold coins, diamonds, or pizza coupons. Variables are like these chests. You give them names to identify what's inside. Here, gold coins holds 5, diamonds holds 6. And pizza coupons? Well, sadly, it holds 0. But here's a pro tip. Always declare variables before using them. It's good programming practice. Declaring variables means creating your treasure chest before putting stuff in. In JavaScript, we've got 3 main ways to declare variables: var, let, and const. Var is the oldest method, but we rarely use it today unless we're writing code for really old browsers. Instead, use let for values that change and const for values that don't. Think of const as a lock on your chest. You can't change what's inside. Here's a quick rule of thumb. Always use const, unless you need to be able to change the value. For example, if you're storing constant values like prices, use const. If you're calculating something, use let. Now let's talk about variable names, which are called identifiers in JavaScript. These are the labels for your treasure chests. Identifiers need to follow some naming rules. Identifiers can contain letters, numbers, dollar signs, and underscores. Identifiers must start with a letter, dollar sign, or underscore. And identifiers can't be reserved words like let or const. Pro tip, identifiers are case sensitive. Car name with a capital N is different from car name without any capital letters. Here's a cool thing. In JavaScript, the equals sign doesn't mean equal to, like in math. It's an assignment operator. It stores the value on the right into the variable on the left. Look at this example. It wouldn't make any sense in normal math. X equals itself plus 3. But in JavaScript, it makes perfect sense. Using the assignment operator, this assigns the value of X plus 3 to X. See? It recalculates X to 8 by adding 3 to the existing value. Variables can hold different things. For example, numbers or strings. Numbers are straightforward, but strings, those are text values written inside quotes. Just remember, put quotes around text, but not around numbers. Here's something fun. You can do math with numbers in JavaScript, but if you combine strings, it is called concatenation. Careful though, if a number is in quotes, JavaScript will treat it as a string. Watch this. We didn't intend to add these like that. We wanted to add them like numbers. Let's remove the quotes and try again. And that's the magic of JavaScript variables. Remember, they're just containers for your data. Use const for constants, let for changeable values, and skip var unless you're coding for dinosaurs. Thanks for watching. Like and subscribe to get notified about our latest videos. For more coding tips and tricks, keep it locked right here on w3schools.com. Don't forget to try out what you've learned in our interactive editor. Happy coding!